You go on the road for the first time. You're able to get a point down in Durham. What's kind of the feeling after coming back from your first road test of the season, knowing that you got another pretty big series coming this weekend in the gut?
Well, I hate to cut you off, Jack, like I did last week, which is not real good Canadian manners. So first, I just wanted to say to the women's soccer team, what an outstanding season. And that the men's ice hockey team is behind the men's soccer team going tomorrow night, which I hope everybody goes to, by the way. And actually, it's funny to use those two teams. We're trying to emulate what they're doing, even going on the road. We're trying to build here a culture of performance, which you've seen from both soccer teams here. A culture that understands what it takes to win. Where we are right now, we're trying to pound the positive all the time. We're trying to have an honest appraisal of where we are. So to answer your question specifically, after coming from a road weekend like that at UNH for our first road trip, we are almost healthy for the first time this season, even since the beginning of the season. I'm real pleased with where we were to be able to grind that win out. All of our wins have been from behind, which is something that I'm proud of. I don't ever want to be playing from behind, but those are good lessons to take into the playoffs at the end of the season. So I guess in a long-winded way of answering your question, Jack, is that this weekend, I think we got closer to our identity. When you go on the road, you have a chance to spend time together as teammates and coaches. Those bus trips, they're not always fun. Like, it's a bunch of hours away, and you build relationships in that. So I'm really pleased with where we were from this weekend. I felt that we could have won the first game as well, too.
Welcoming one of the best teams in Hockey East right now to the gut this weekend, what's the game plan for Providence?
I don't think we really worry about who we play. It's how we play, Ange. Providence is not even one of the best teams in Hockey East. They're one of the best teams in the country. Like, they're really, really good. Starting from Nate Lehman all the way down, I think this is a team, almost like the women's soccer and the men's soccer. It sounds like I'm trying to emulate a bunch of teams here, when really we're trying to be who we are, but they're an excellent team. They play hard. They play heavy. They're a team that likes to feed on turnovers. So we have to be really smart with the puck. We have to manage the puck, be secure with the puck, and not give them free opportunities. This is a team that we want to make beat us two times or three times. And by that, I mean, if they put a puck in behind us, we want to get to that puck first. They can't put a puck behind us and then beat us to that puck. Or if it's a battle for the puck and it's one puck they have, and then we can't let them have the second puck. They're too good. So we have to make sure we respect the opponent, but really worry about the way that we're playing. And I'm very pleased with the way we're playing right now. There's a lot of things we're doing really well, especially our young players contributing so much. And then in that victory against UNH, the veterans having such a presence in that game as well. So I'm really pleased with where we're going.
Obviously there are pluses and minuses to it, but when you're trying to kind of build this program back to being kind of nationally relevant, yep, nationally competitive again, how much of an advantage is it to be able to test yourselves against these really good teams every single week?
Yeah, you almost answered that for me, Jack. I think that the fact that you're testing against the best, even going back to last year, every single game we played was against a top 10 or top 12 team in the country at that time we played. And Maine, that weekend, they were just pushing on that level too. They were a really, really well-organized team. So for us to be able to be one of the best, we have to be competitive with the best. Every game that we didn't win this year, I felt that we were in all those games. How many one-goal games we have in Quinnipiac, that's a 2-0 game, but I was really pleased with that too. And there's pieces of the game we're always going to have to change, and pieces of our game that we have to have an honest appraisal of. But we're going to build confidence in practice through repetition on those things that we need to get better at, and we're going to keep playing the young guys. Everybody makes the playoffs in Hockey East this year, so it's not going to be like that forever. So this is a gift to us that we have this opportunity, knowing that we're building towards that game 35, game 36, hopefully game 37 this year. And our young guys are going to have a huge part of that, and we have to play them right now.
What's the identity of this team right now?
I think, Ange, that we're still finding it. I guess if you ask me what I would like this team to be, I would like this team to be a team that understands that we're never going to be, and I don't really want to be, a team that has a 5-on-5 power play mentality, which means we're not going to be fancy. I don't think that the fancy teams have the best identity, because when you get to the playoff is so tight, the checking is so hard, fancy teams don't succeed in those circumstances, in my opinion anyway. So I want this team to be proud of the work ethic, proud of understanding that we will have to manufacture offense, and that, you know, one thing we can control is how hard we work. And if we work hard all the time, which seems to be such a cliche, but it starts in practice. It starts with showing up on time for the game. If it's a 7 o'clock game, we can't show up 20 minutes into the game. Like, it has to be from the beginning. And then really that they have pride in what we're trying to build together. So the seniors who are leaving us understand that they have a chance to put their own thumbprint on this team and know that they're going to leave this place a better place than it was for them this year, when maybe we didn't have all the wins, but they're going to have pride in that as well. And then at the end of the day, it's just 30 guys on this team that care about each other.
Coach O, what can you say about Ray being named to the Latvian?
Oh my gosh. So Ray Vitolins will be coming in a minute here. And Ray was, he's actually special to me because he was one of the first recruits that I was able to bring in when I got this job. We had a mutual connection in Europe, and I got to know Ray a little bit, and I think Ray is an NHL player. I've had many friends of mine from the great country of Latvia. I've been there many times. I was in a world championships there. I love this country very much, and Ray, to me, is the epitome of what we're trying to bring here. Ray came in as a highly skilled player, offensive player his whole life, and then he had to come into Hockey East and realize how hard it is to score. And this guy led our team in scoring as a freshman last year in Hockey East, and now we give him more responsibility. And I had a discussion with him earlier today, and we just talked about how hard it is. It's never going to be easy. So from Ray's journey, coming from a country far away where I don't think they really learned about Vermont in their geography lessons, and to come in here and to be a leader so fast, to bring offense to us, and then also just to have that working attitude that we want to have. And it starts, I know his family is a hardworking family, and they're actually here visiting this week, so it's really nice for them to come and watch their own son play, and we're thrilled to have Ray here. Let's go UVM soccer. Don't forget the shirt that Ray Vitolins is wearing is on sale at the Davis Center. Right? There we go. All right. There's my plug for the day. Let's go UVM soccer. Woo!